Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Alex Vaughn. Once again, cool guys from Towing Company are here. Hi there guys, welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 13:14 hours on Tuesday, July 26, 2016. I'm Chris Boden, you're not, and that's the tow truck with the van on it. So the van's hosed. I just told him don't block the dumpsters, so we'll see. I don't know, you tell him where you want it.
Right here.
In the handicap spot. Because if he puts it in the front one, he'll block the door. So we're having a day. I'll fill you in as we go. I got shit. There, is that better, guys? All right. She'll be fine.
Totally.
We got it here.
Yeah, it's here.
It's here. I hear there's only projection screens in the back.
Projection screens and a handful of little miscellaneous
crap,
but nothing too terribly important. And this load could all be done with forklift.
So you suck, by the way, for one-upping me, you asshole.
What did I do?
I had a whole thing planned. I had a team of people involved, and you one-upped me and beat me at my own game.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'll break it down for you as we go. So, she's fucked up. So we do a van at this point. It's headed to scrapyard bed.
Well, we can look, see how much it can cost for transmissions. Because if it's only like $2,000, it's cheaper than buying a new van.
That is. This thing has 330,000 miles.
I know.
334,000.
334,000.
The engine was still running great. We may have just fucked it now. Who knows?
Okay.
That's why we need a real mechanic.
All right. Hey! We got a real mechanic, dude. Kind of.
We got a YouTube mechanic.
We got a YouTube mechanic, okay.
Google it. You gotta Google it.
Katie, let's go get water. Guessing you might have done that once or twice.
Oh, right. Yeah. Well, I was in there quick in the cop block track. Yeah.
Thank you. it's still not in the spot. You gotta let it roll a little more there. You're almost there.
Yeah,
see how the
Jerry's car is news, man.
Ah,
fuck it. Alright, we're all set.
What's your name, sir?
Matt.
Matt, I want to thank
you,
sir.
No problem, thank you. Good day.
Thanks to all the cool guys at Complete Automotive Repair, West Siders, on Alpine. So have I got a story for you.
Oh, is it?
All right, everyone, gather around for stories.
He just now saw the note.
No, I saw it when I was filming.
Okay, okay, here, I'm handing this off to you.
All right, come here. I got it because...
Do we want to wait for Jesse?
Yeah, we'll wait a minute because he'll get a kick out of this.
He's coming.
He had to wait for, he was waiting for the truck to come.
Oh.
Come and go.
Yeah, so we're crossing expeditions off of towing vehicle possibilities.
That truck right now, it's fucking popping the wheel. I know. He's about to probably rip off that Stinger jet.
We need to go have somebody that's kind of heavy sit in the front seat. They lower the front of the car.
I was sitting in the front seat on the way back.
Oh, it wasn't Evan?
Yeah, it towed really bad.
Because we were looking at my truck and it was rather low, and I thought, oh, by the time we all get in.
With no hard drive.
Does
it work in this? It might, but we have no cradles for it. You don't need cradles.
Come on back a little bit. You're doing good. Come on back. I'm back. So we got right about there is good. Stop right there. Thank you. Come on inside real quick.
Thank you. I'm all right.
Come on in here a minute. You gotta hear this.
I'm on my way. What did I do?
No, it's you're fine. You actually did amazing.
That's new.
Okay, so here's what you don't know. We knew yesterday that there would be a giant epic donation pickup today. Everything was all set, preparations were made, life's good. We knew we had to take the van, and we knew we'd have to take the big trailer. Okay. So, after the past week of death weather, like stepped into a sauna, yesterday for a few hours the weather broke, and it was nice. So I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna take Big Boat out. I'm gonna try this out, because I, before last night, had not actually gotten to take the Big Boat out. I'd only driven it one time for burgers and boats. So I take Boat, I was like, I'm gonna do the whole thing. I took a safety buddy, I took Melissa with me, because I don't go boating alone. So we go out, load everything up, and I asked her before I left, and she had Batman help. And I was like, is everything set? Everything's ready to go. And she asked you, is there gas in it? And you said,
she
said
she'd fill it up.
It's fine.
She said she was going to fill it up. I said, cool.
And I asked her, and she said, everything's fine. I'm like, okay, cool. So we grab the boat, off we go to Grand Haven.
We're both in trouble for this, so don't worry.
Last night in one particularly awesome way. I don't do so well with car rides in motion, which is hilarious because I have any boats. So because if I rode in the van, I'd be decorating the dashboard. I drove my car. Melissa took the van. We met in Grand Haven. We go all the way out to Spring Lake, which is the last boat launch before you're actually in Grand Haven. We put the boat in without incident, everything's fucking awesome. And just as we get the boat in the water, I think, I should check that gas can. So we check the gas can. It's about 3/4 inch, maybe an inch of gas in about that gas can. And I'm like, hey, I asked you. And she's like, oh no, Batman says it's cool. So I'm like, okay.
We decided we were going to tool.
It's fine, it's cool. We got this because we're like.
You said there was enough to just tool around.
Hey, I'm telling the story.
Okay.
We're like a block and a half from the gas station, so it's late. It's too late to be putting a boat in the water, but all right, a little fumble fuckage, and if this is my problem for the day, I'm cool with that. So we go, we get gas, we come back, and off we go. Take the boat out for a bit, and I didn't like go over, I just went like under the bridge and back because I just wanted to like want to drive the boat. So I drove the boat, everything's cool, boat worked great, Batman drove the boat, everything great, everything fine, cool. Come back, trailer works fine, lights are good, thanks to Jesse. Everything is glorious. We get all the way back to just this side
of cover.
No, it started acting up in Coopersville, and I got off the highway.
Yeah, it started up in Coopersville. The van, like, goes, and she freaks out. We hop off at the last Coopersville exit. I was like, it's cool. We'll take Garfield, Remembrance, Leonard. We'll be fine. We got back ways home. We got Jesse on call. Shit gets really bad. We got Batman on call. But by now, it's, like, fucking 11:30 at night. So we make it all the way to Covell and Leonard, the big church up there. Dead. So we just barely get it limped into the church park. And by now, it's 11:45, almost 12. I'm like, well, so the van's out of gas too! Fine! So, it's okay. It's cool. I was following right along behind her, so grab Melissa, we come back here. Get a gas can, fill the gas can, got 2 gallon gas can, which is this one right here, which you know is legit because it's got an actual cop on the back, but she's black and a woman just to make it legit. They got all the things in there. So, put 2 gallons of gas in the van, bring the van back, and all this time I'm thinking, Batman, you fucker. So I'm like, all right, I got a plan. So this morning, we fill the gas can. So he's got a full 2 gallons. We hide the gas can in Megan's car. Because we know there's no way he's going to make it through like 3 stops, all the way up to Rockford. No, it's not going to happen. He's going to run out of gas. He's only got like a gallon and a half in him. So we hide the gas can in Megan's car. We give Megan $50 to make sure that when you stall out on the side of the road, you've got gas, and you've got enough money to fill the tank.
She was going
to
fill it up last night. I asked her this morning.
Yeah, that was the point.
That was the point.
That was the point. She said she wanted to run out of gas. And we put on the bottom.
You asked me if I put gas in it. I did.
Of the gas can is a note that says, when someone asks if there is gas in it, don't fucking guess. Okay, and it was to be this funny thing if you're on the side of the road, like, rah, 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 and you tip it up, because when you tip it up, you're looking at the bottom, and there's no, and funny, and a lesson learned, and everything's cool, because you got gas to get out of there, you got enough to fill it, you're totally cool, total support system, because you got Megan there, so there's a second vehicle. Everything was going to be fucking hilarious.
And then?
And you destroy the transmission in the van. I put so many, there was like 3 people in on this. We had a whole thing.
This whole
orchestrated.
And maybe you make the van run out of gas, maybe broke it even more. What else? They don't like doing that.
I know, but I'm like, we've done it 50 times. Yeah, I'll roll the dice for
that. That last
that
mix,
last
piece
time.
Of sediment got
yeah. So
blew the hose.
We had a whole plan, man.
So like, you got there, he's like, transmission's fucked, and I'm just giggling. I was like, no, it's not. You're just not quite out of gas yet. It's gonna be like, just go. You're gonna be fine. It's gonna be okay. Just keep going. You gotta do like 2 more miles. It's gonna run right up.
The smell of burning transmission told me the transmission.
Yeah, so, there was a funny smell.
So now you know
like,
the whole story.
That's not my car.
A whole team of people worked together for a funny thing to fuck with you, and you fucked with it even worse.
I yield before the mighty power of the Batman.
And you get a memento, you put that in the case. Alright, it's 1327. We have now, because this is the other part of what you don't know. Tell them where you stalled out, Batman!
I stalled out on West River Drive, just outside of the 5th, 3rd ballpark, the back entrance.
Oh, God.
Wait.
That's like Catch Cruisers?
Oh, no.
The next one up.
The next
okay.
Where McDonald's is, close to there.
Right there. But that stoplight, I was coming up to it, and I stalled out.
And what lane were you in, Batman?
The left lane.
The left lane.
You know, they merge at...
Oh, yeah!
I was in the left lane.
I've been listening to the traffic jam.
Backup.
I'm sure. Great. I saw. Police
scanner. I saw.
Oh yeah, a kind sheriff showed up.
It was funny though. I saw a cop car. I was like, cool. He'll turn on his lights. We'll be safe. Cause I put up my triangles, like you guys do.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm a little still paranoid because people are being assets at this point.
Yeah.
Like they, at one point before I put the triangles up, they were coming. There's a median lane there.
Okay.
They were coming up and just blowing by me. Not yet, like slow state. Oh, yeah. They're like, we're gonna make the green.
Fuck.
So I put the triangle lights to at least stop that. And I was like, I see this cop. And I was like, oh, cool, we'll have help. Blows on by. Lake County Sheriff. And then eventually,
we don't work here.
Actually, Kent County Sheriff showed up. He started blocking
He parked a little further back, so. Oh, suddenly everyone's paying attention.
You do a lot when you have a little blanket like that.
Yeah, yeah.
He did, though.
I didn't do a thing. I didn't do a damn thing.
He may or may not have broken
several
to get to me faster by maybe going the wrong way. But, you know, he got to me faster. The Muppet had one job.
I just crossed over.
One job. And I called him up. I told him, bring a jack so we can get the trailer off the van.
Yeah, because you're going to have it because it's heavy.
I brought a jack.
In his truck.
And I left it in my truck.
We switched trucks.
So how'd you get the trailer?
Thankfully, the nice man with AAA had a jack.
And we were able to get
it off. Just barely. We got it off the van. And I had to sit my fat ass on the bumper so that his would sit low enough so we could hook his trailer.
And then I knew when they took the jack out because my wife's truck went, oh no! And it just sat.
It just barely got on there and I thought I missed the thing.
All right, so I have a plan. I have a plan.
Hi there guys, I'm Chris Boden and this group of people around me here is the Geek Group. And all of these people have been working hard today in order to get computers for the Southwest Michigan area so that we can do computers for family. And today, while doing a donation pickup for those computers, for, this is the largest pickup we've ever done, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
It's four Gaylords of
computers. So while doing the largest pickup of donations ever, we managed to destroy the transmission in our ratty old cargo van, which has 334,000 miles on it. It's done its time. We got it when it was at the end of its service life. It was donated to us, and we've had that thing for years.
4 years.
Yeah.
4 or 5 years.
We are in desperate need of a generic utility cargo van or small box truck, just a straight truck, nothing serious. Like, we don't need air brakes and stuff. We just need a basic truck. We need a vehicle. We don't care if it's a big beefy pickup truck or whatever. We're not that fussy. But we desperately need a vehicle for donation pickups. If you can help, please contact me. Comment on this video or comment on the Facebook post down below there in, as the kids are calling it these days, the doobly-doo. Comment in. I don't know who started that, but like, links are in the doobly-doo. I don't know that. But oh my God, we need your help. I know that somebody in this town owns a company that has, they go through a lot of trucks, I mean, delivery services, stuff like that. A lot of these get donated. I know that NPR and things like that are real big on vehicle donations because they sell them and keep the money. It's a good fundraising system. But we actually need it for donation pickups and stuff like that. So if you can help, please comment and let me know. We're a 501c3, there's a tax write-off for you, there's warm fuzzies and all that jazz, and Batman will come and do topless belly dancing at your wedding if you will donate a truck to us right now. Work it, girl. Work it. We're going to lunch with that.
That's it.
We'll be back after this.
I'm done.
And through every key. And then it's got, over here, it's got a little deburring press. Make sure it's all nice and smooth.
Yeah, yeah.
Pull it out, and now you get yourself a new stamp, which probably is real hard to read. It just went through everything.
All right. And we got lots of these in stock.
A few boxes.
See if you can find somewhere where we can get more.
Okay.
I wonder if we can change that and change the font.
Maybe. I don't have a...
All right, let me drive. I want to show this in a blog. No, give me your chair. Ugh. All right, guys. Time is 16:04 hours, and we have a graphotype focus machine. And here's the maker plate down here. There's everything you need to know. It's from Cleveland. All right. So, Batman.
Yep.
Load up a thing. Here, I'm going to hand that off to you.
Opens up a little bit.
Just hold on to it. Just like that. The and tip. Then flip down, and then you shove it over. Now, you got this guy is your feed line. So, you got four lines.
pipe on. So right now you're on line one.
Okay.
And then you can click it in for different lines. And then it'll come over and hit this stop. If you want it to do the little schmoopy thing, you push that in, it'll come over and do the rolly thing. Watch your fingers.
Yeah.
If the key gets stuck, this is the reset lever.
So this happens so often that there's a reset lever.
Okay, well, you saw me do it a couple times. Yeah. Right? Just got a little stuck.
All right. What is
this one?
Okay, that's all the actual.
That's how it figures out which letter.
What is this?
That's because that when you punch a key, it throws up the letter, and it spins until it stops on it, and that tells it to punch down.
Oh, I see.
Three little boxes of plates, and I'm guessing there's like a couple hundred per a box.
So this comes up like when you hit Y.
Yeah.
It raises this. And then this thing's spinning around, and it trips up on that and fires the lever.
Approximately 250 per box.
How many boxes?
We got one partial, we got that one, one brand new one. So we got a handful.
About 750.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm gonna try this out. Turn it up. I'm gonna turn it up.
Switch right by your knee. It'll start spinning and start typing.
Oh. Yeah, you can see the spinny thing.
Slightly turned.
Why is the shift key upside down?
Probably because it was replaced at some point. I don't know. It looks different from the other one. That's shift lock, shift key.
That is so fucking cool.
It's so satisfying to use, isn't it?
Okay, you want to get right down in here. Watch this.
Ready? Right there is where you're looking.
Mm-hmm.
My father taught me this, how to reset.
Turn. You just push it and then click this in one.
Click in one. Yeah, that's really fun.
Shit.
Fuck.
There's no backspin.
At first I saw this, I thought it was like an eraser to smooth the blade back out for me. It's a typewriter. Makes
Now the cool thing is there are astute blog viewers who at this point know exactly what I typed.
Are you done typing?
So now how do I get it out?
If you want to get this as a release and bring it over here,
okay.
And do the burning thing. Push it out, turn it off. I definitely would turn it off.
Yeah, I wouldn't stick my hand
in. So then this lever releases your plate.
Yeah, it overlapped the lines.
So,
oh, a little bit, yeah.
You gotta make sure you're pressing in until it. they're going very gently.
Yeah. Well,
you can use
a
little bit more pee.
I didn't see the dog for it. But there's little teeth down there. There's a dog for it.
So when it's all the way up, that isn't the first line. You have to click it in. That's why I fucked it up.
That's your release. So drag it over. Then you can tell where you're at because you got a little graph line there.
Oh. Okay. That's.
So you can do actual spacing on it.
That's really, really quite something. Quite what this does. Oh!
Fast spacing.
No, that's just move the space.
Technically it would be back space because you're going backwards when you're typing.
This is really, really
nice. And Bruce, show him the other one. This one does the stamping on the tabs you made. In fact, technically, we could put this in and stamp it.
There is so much awesome happening here. We got to get high-speed video of this, because there's shit up here going on, the hammer drive. That's really neat. This is a display piece. All right, what we need to figure out how to do is we got to figure out how to get more of these. Because this is a thing we could take, like...
I could look up and see if someone still makes
these. See if you can find out.
Or we can find a stamp there.
I'll bet somewhere on eBay there's a shit pot full of these. They're really soft aluminum. It's designed for very low-run letterpress.
Yep.
Find me more of these. Because they got those on eBay. Oh, if we could find a way to use this to make dog tags.
Well, see, it's got these, and there's a second little mount, which tells me that there's probably a mount that you can put in here for doing dog tags or something along those lines.
Let's find out. Because this would be an awesome, awesome demo. Like, I was thrilled when I was a kid, and I put a penny in the machine, cranked it, and got a steamboat.
Now you can just come out with your name.
Yeah,
and
if you could have a penny with your name on it, man, that'd be bad as hell.
You having issues over there, Bruce?
I was trying the fast load, but it
didn't work so well.
No. All
right, it's a graphotype.
And then that's the addressograph.
Which isn't nearly as cool as a linotype, but I'll take what I can get. So why does this plug in? What's going on?
This is the opposite half of this machine.
This is the printer side.
Yep. Go ahead and plug us in.
All right.
So when we started out with this guy, mm-hmm. They get fancy, you got your plate to go on, so you can actually read it.
This is from 1972.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you want to do a mass mailing, you get one of these. You grab your stack, you drop it in.
Okay.
Load it up.
This is an envelope feeder of some sort too.
And we'll pretend this is an envelope. So you go ahead and set up. You've got your stop, so you can do like large envelopes, little stuff, whatnot. So let's turn it on. And if you look down underneath, we got a nice little foot pedal.
Oh yeah.
Very high quality and fancy.
That's serious. Oh my god.
You can do stuff by hand. So
repeat, constant, skip.
So now you.
And every time it addresses one, it drops the card out the bottom. I fucked it. Failure to feed.
It's half fed, so.
Yeah. Oh, it's all fucked.
They made this work so smooth and awesome. Not balls.
There we go.
Okay. Well, no, hold on. Take that one out. That one's kinked.
Oh, that's your problem.
You might need
sensor?
To reset it.
Oh, okay.
Stamp paper. We've already stamped the metal with that machine. Now it stamps paper.
So the metal
is... Metal becomes a stamp.
Okay.
This is how they used to do magazines.
So you broke that one.
Hang on, I'll fix it.
It doesn't lift.
Doesn't lift, it's bolted down.
Already?
Here.
Needs a dead blow.
Just find the other one.
And we have drawers full of these cards. Yeah. The addresses of a bajillion people in Grand Rapids.
Not just New York, New Jersey, Louisiana, Kansas.
I got 1962 here for Durango, Colorado.
This company cut keys for about everyone.
The Basin Bowl Corporation, John Hunt in Durango, Colorado.
Yeah. That's why I was saying earlier, it's like the cutters.
I kind of want to mail these off to all these addresses.
Oh yeah, like here's your plate?
Yeah, here, this is for Barnard College, John Kiesling, Milbank Hall, New York, 1971. That's really cool.
So here's the inside.
Here's the print ribbon. How do you ink the ribbon?
Engineering at its finest.
Electromechanical, yeah.
Yeah. I was thinking magnetical, I was like, electromagnetical?
Mechanical, yes.
This thing is just fascinating.
Kick it, yo!
This is a really interesting method of anything.
Is this side? No, Batman. Okay, I get it. You gotta put spaces between your nas.
Apparently.
That's cool.
Ooh, that mechanism is just enticingly fascinating. It comes up with this. I would not know how to keep in designing that.
Yeah, no.
It's crazy this was made before CNC machines were even a thing. You say shift lock, I don't believe you.
I've heard that from machines.
What I need to do next is figure out how to make this steam powered.
That would require so much steam.
Not really.
Big ass friggin'. Harris, reach your hand right there.
No.
There we go. That
only
was much
works
better.
For politicians. Much better. So this is the first step, the very first step of every computer that comes in the big computer donations.
We blow the dust out of them.
That's one of those ones.
Are you having fun?
Oh yeah, tons.
Okay.
Always having fun here.
It's a lot of boxes.
Not even begun.
Are these done?
No.
That's next?
None of these things have been gone through yet. We're okay. Just getting these guys done.
All right, cool.
Because they're big and powerful.
Yeah. All right. We'll be back.
Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Alex Vaughn.